I tell them what my uncle told me. My uncle was a master sergeant in the Air Force, and he traveled around the world operating rod and gun clubs for the Air Force. And I told him I was going to be a professional musician. He said, well, I want to tell you, it's one of the hardest jobs in the world. So you're going to have to work your ass off. You're not going to make any money. You're not going to get any appreciation, which is 90% correct. And that's what I tell them, you know, is don't expect a number one record. I mean, you may get it, but you may have to work 10 years, just like Bruce Hornsby. You know, he was an overnight sensation, but he was messing with that stuff for 8 or 9 years before he had that hit. And a lot of times that happened. Glenn, the same way. It's a rough business. Well, there's a period in my life when I was trying to write standards. A guy, a baritone player for Tower of Power, came up to me one day, Doc, I think his name is, and he said, Leon, how do you get all those people to cut your records? He said, I've had 12 number one records. Nobody has ever cut any of them but Tower of Power. And I said, well, maybe your lick's too complicated. I don't know. I mean, standards, when you write standards, when you first hear a standard, it sounds just like a shitty little tune, you know. And then you come back and you hear it later, and then you hear it 20 years later. They're different. When I wrote Masquerade, I was trying to write a standard. I wrote Song for You. I was trying to write a song that Ray Charles and Frank Sinatra could sing, a blues song that Ray Charles and Frank Sinatra could sing. 20 years ago, I don't know what the number is now, but 20 years ago, Song for You had been cut 129 times. I don't know, that was before Ray Charles cut it. Masquerade was cut 43 times before George Benson cut it. I mean, I try to write standards. I don't try to write hits. I liked Song for You. Herb Alpert had bought that grand from Western Studio 3. It was my favorite grand piano in Los Angeles. And Herb bought it. And when I played that, I'd never played it that way before. I never played that intro before. I just, all off the top of my head, I mean, which is the story of my life, really. And basically, I was trying to sing like Bonnie Bramlett. At that time, we was all trying to sing like Bonnie Bramlett. You know, I mean, she was a person that had a quite unusual singing style. And all the girls were copying it, and I was trying to sing it on that song. A limousine driver told me one time, he's in New York, who's hauling Aretha Franklin, and he got to the destination, and that song came on. And she said she made him sit there and play that 20 times. She listened to it over and over again. It was kind of shitty singing. I really didn't have it figured out ever, but that was the first song that I did.
I've been so many places in my life and time. I've sung a lot of songs. I've made some bad rhymes. I've acted out my love in stages with 10,000.